Focus. Ideate. Innovate. Enable.
Important, but making your money work for you is even more so. No matter what your financial goals or aspirations are, we are here to help you achieve just that. You've tuned into another episode of NSE FinWiz powered by CNBC TV 18, and I'm your host, Nithya Balakrishnan. Today, my team and I have traveled to the campus of a brand that symbolizes fitness, attitude, sport, and health. This is the headquarters of Puma Sports India in Bengaluru.
Puma is one of the world's leading sports brands, known for its footwear, apparel and accessories. For over 65 years, this brand has been producing the most innovative products for athletics aficionados. Puma distributes its products in more than 120 countries, including India, which is poised to be among Puma's top 5 markets by 2020. NSE FinWiz, with its theme, Dream On, engaged with employees of Puma in Bengaluru to understand their thoughts on financial planning and to help them plan their goals better.
NSE FinWiz came with an interesting proposition. Financial planning is one of the most difficult aspects for the young workforce which is entering our current corporate environment. We at Puma have very, very young, energetic crowd. But the understanding of financial planning is somewhat not focused on.
According to me, financial literacy is something about knowing about your finances well, knowing what instruments to invest in so that you can make a sound decision. Because with what has been happening in last 2 years of me investing is whatever they suggest me, I have to go with it. And then later on, I realize, although I have been able to save tax using that instrument, but my wealth hasn't really grown as much as I expected it to be.
The question which I would ask to the expert is, if a person who has started investments in the early 20s, would debt instruments really be a judicial choice? Because debt instruments are giving close to 8% or 9% of return, and that too the lock-in period to make those tax-free is 3 years. So should exposure only be in stocks and equity mutual funds, or there should be some allotment which we should do to debt instruments as well?
I am not investing as of now, but I am not aware because I've just started. I want to know where I can invest and where I can get the best returns.
Hello and welcome to Season 5 of NSE FinWiz powered by CNBC TV 18. And I'm your host, Nithya Balakrishnan. Joining me on the show tonight are our financial experts, Anil Rego and Lavai Navlaki. Thank you so much, sirs, for joining us. And we're in the campus of one of India's biggest sporting brands, the headquarters of Puma Sports India here in Bengaluru. And before taking it any further, I'd like to talk about what is the matter of the moment. We're probably looking at a very interesting bull market. And given this current scenario, how best can we make our money work for us? How important is it to invest into the Indian equity markets? Mr. Navlaki, if I can ask you to step up in this conversation.
So I think investing in equity is something that you do because you want to protect yourself against inflation. You have some significant goals in life and you have a long-term outlook. So you're not looking at investing in equity like you're playing maybe roulette. Mm-hmm. You're actually doing it consciously, systematically, with due thought. And you're, monitoring this regularly to make sure that it's aligned with what your goals are.
Well, if I can ask you, Mr. Rego, a lot of the fears of investing into the equity markets primarily revolves around volatility. And given the fact that you don't want to risk losing money, how would you suggest one has to enter or stay invested into the equity markets?
Yeah, equity markets are volatile, but there are strategies to actually manage your volatility. One approach that you can take is you can, first of all, diversify, which means that you have it across stocks, across various funds, across mutual fund categories as well, large cap, mid cap, flexi cap. You also have strategies like systematic investment, which possibly is one of the best thing for many of us to do who are salaried. The third aspect is possibly that, you know, as you look at a longer tenure, you know, equity becomes safer. So if you look at a one-year tenure, for example, when you look at past history of markets and how the index has done since inception, you lose money 40% of the time if you look at a one-year cycle. But once you look at over 3 or 5 years, you know, that loss percentage sort of comes down. So, you know, again, you know, look at it longer term, look at it systematically and diversify. And so these are possibly the three mantras I can give.
Three tips. On one hand, you have vehicles like your savings bank account, PPF, etc., which is definitely going to give you nominal rate of returns. On the other hand, you have the equity markets that not many people believe will give you returns because there is a, you know, possibility of losing money. Do you think, you know, looking at option one just because it's nominal and you don't tend to lose money is better than option two? Would you prefer to play the safer card?
So I think whenever you're making investments, there are two or three objectives that you have from your investment. There is one element of having liquidity, that I want cash on hand because I might suddenly need it. I have a plan for this weekend. Then there's an element of I want to take some risk and have growth of my money. So I want my money to actually work for me. So I want it to grow. And there's a third element, which is to do with safety. And that is to do with, let me make sure that the money that is there doesn't lose value. Now, the unfortunate thing is that people put them all together and say that I want every investment of mine to meet all these three criteria. There is no single investment that will meet all the three criteria. So if you leave money in your savings bank because you need it on the weekend, then that's only meeting the requirement of liquidity. When I'm investing in equity, I'm looking at growth. So automatically, as Anil mentioned, it is important to look at time horizon. If it's longer, then the risk comes down. And the third part, which is your safety piece, I think it's very important to look at safety versus tax and inflation. So if you leave money in your fixed deposit and you're getting, say, 6.75% today, and you happen to be in the 30% tax bracket, you're actually only getting 4.5% after tax. And you have to see whether inflation for you, and forget the government published numbers, for you individually, it will be different for each one of you. What's the rate of inflation for you?
Well, for a lot of us who have not yet invested into the equity markets, Mr. Rego, what would you think are significantly good vehicles to approach the equity markets?
Yeah, I think one of the best ways of going about it is the mutual funds. And like I suggested, the SIP route. You can set aside maybe a certain part of your income. Say, whatever it is, you say, I'll set aside, say, 20%, 25%. Put in a thumb rule and ensure that, you know, that goes away, maybe even before you end up spending it. So that, I think, is possibly the best way to go about it. And while you put in mutual funds again, I would suggest you know, diversify it across a few funds. And if you want to be a little more careful, you can also use, say, balanced funds. You can go a little more lower risk in terms of MIPs, which possibly have, you know, only about 25% equity in it. And you also have today what is called as dynamic asset allocation funds.
Fair enough. Now, a lot of people believe, Mr. Navlaki, you know, let's wait for the market to crash because you enter on dips and exit when the market goes high. Is that a thumb rule that most of us can think is optimum to follow?
I think it's very difficult for people to determine today, is this on its way up or down? And what is going to be tomorrow? What is going to be next week? It's extremely tough to do. I don't think we ever venture out as advisors to mention that even to clients, because we don't know. Remember that I'm investing in equity, it has to be for the long term. It cannot be, you know, based on how well my investment does, I will decide in June, you know, whether I can take a holiday to Europe or to Far East Asia, depending on how the market is.
Well, thank you so much. And on that note, it's time to slip into a quick break right here on NSE FinWiz. But stay tuned on the other side, the importance of goals during financial planning. Welcome back to NSE FinWiz, powered by CNBC TV 18, and I'm in conversation with Navai Lavlaki as well as Mr. Anil Rego. Not a lot of us realize that setting goals is important. So what role do goals play in financial planning?
Whether it's child's education, whether it's retirement, whether it's buying a second home. So the simple way I would sort of suggest people look at it is to list down, saying how much money do I need, when do I need it, for what purpose. Because only if you have put that down, you can work backwards with a financial planner to to see how much money do you need to put aside, either by way of lump sum or by way of monthly saving and investment, to help you achieve that goal. I think with youngsters, what happens is a lot of us financial planners mm-hmm. tend to add retirement as one of their goals, and they say, we are not thinking about retirement at all. So, okay, forget retirement, do the other goals first, but just get used to the fact that you have some goals, and if you start working towards them, take some of them which are short term, so you'll feel good when you achieve them as well, and then you know by experience that, yeah, you know, it helped me it's to get possible. To that goal, now I'll do the same thing for something that's 3 years later or 5 years later.
Fantastic. Well, into this conversation comes Ashmita Goel, who's from the merchandising department. And Mr. Lava, if you can jump in on this, the dream is to accumulate 5 times current salary saved in the next 6 to 7 years. And the corpus is about 50 lakh rupees. Now, on a monthly basis, she can save 17,000 rupees. And the time horizon, like I said, is about 5 to 6 years. What would be the best route of investment for her to take?
I think one important thing that will happen because of what you are starting now is that you will mentally make up your mind that you are going to put aside a certain part of your savings into investment. And while we are thinking of it as a fixed amount today, what will actually happen is that you will be able to contribute much more every year to that kitty. And as you start experiencing some of the actual returns on your investment, you will feel more confident to do more. So typically what we tell people is that based on your earning minus compulsory sort of expenses, take aside and see, that means you will have some saving, and then there is discretionary expenditure that you have to do. But from that net sort of saving, put aside something like 50-60% every month into an investment. So that's gone, and now only the rest is remaining. Mm-hmm. So start with a saving or an investment goal rather than a spending goal. That will probably help you. And you can do it in notches. You don't have to stop doing everything tomorrow morning.
Well, we have Ashwin, who's from the merchandising department.
My question is that my dream is to buy a house of around 70 to 1 crore rupees. And I don't want to invest a lot in, and I want to know which is the best medium to invest and grow money. And around I can invest around 10 to 15,000. So if you can guide me.
What I would suggest is you step it up. Maybe start 10,000 rupees today. Keep increasing it over the years as you come closer. Now it's possible that at that point of time, 10 years from now, you may want to buy a 2 crore house, right? So you may just need to keep that in mind and, you know, invest as much as you can. For a need like this, and you're looking at a smaller investment of 10,000 rupees, definitely I would suggest you can look at equity mutual funds, a systematic investment. You could possibly do even a combination of a flexi cap, large cap, and a mid cap fund, or even just maybe two funds, and run it, you know, for the whole tenure. If you need tax saving as well, okay, now these are the tips that, you know, you can use. You know, you go and also make it into an ELSS scheme, right? And then, you know, you have the tax saving as well, which frees up a little bit more of, let's say, your tax money. And that is, will also, you know, so all of these will aid you to be able to achieve your goal much better. And I don't see any reason why you should not be able to achieve your house.
Mr. Navlaki, if a lot of us don't really think that saving towards retirement is mandatory right at an early age. But if you were to say, you know, to the average 28 to 30 year old, keep an X percent off your corpus towards the retirement fund because inflation is going to play party pooper at some point, what would your advice really be in that sense? How would you look at planning for retirement?
Retirement is something that you seriously need to think about because you're going to be fending for it by yourself. So the earlier you start planning for your retirement, mm-hmm. the easier it is for you to achieve your goal. Mm-hmm. And I think you should be also thinking about some sort of money that you'll spend in retirement to reskill yourself or find something productive to do because you need to sort of contribute to the kitty.
Correct.
Right? Because the number of years is going to be really long.
Fantastic. Well, we have Arihant of the Strategic Imitation Department whose corpus, Mr. Ego, is about 12 crores. But also on a monthly basis, he can set aside close to 40,000 crore rupees, which will be increasing every year, he says. And the time horizon is 25 years. With 40,000 per month for about 25 years, is it possible to reach that 12 crore corpus in terms of a good life for him and his family?
Considering the long tenure that you have, And I'm assuming that, you know, you would have other needs as well. So you would do a combination of assets. But for retirement, I think significantly around equity is, you know, what you can do. You can keep the debt investments for maybe the shorter term requirements. However, as you come closer to your retirement age, you would need to sort of systematically reduce it. Keep in mind, you know, the overall asset allocation, you know, and you can, you know, do that. Of course, like Lavai also said, you know, there are other factors beyond just age. So, and you said that you want to manage a little bit of a lower risk approach. So then you can do a combination of, let's say, balanced funds. You can do a combination of large cap funds. You can also do the PPF, which is a very good, say, tax-free avenue. So because there are two parts to, you know, ensuring that you get a better post-tax return, tax and return, right? So there you save the tax out there. And again, the tenure of the PPF is something that is good, and I'm sure you must be doing the PPF as well.
On that note, it's time for another quick break right here on NSE FinWiz, but stay tuned, a lot of action coming up on the other side. Welcome back to Season 5 of NSE FinWiz, and here at the Puma headquarters in Bangalore, we have the young minds eager to ask financial planning questions to our experts. So if we can have the microphone to the lady in red, please, initially.
I don't think, like, for investing for a shorter period of time, if my monthly salary is like 50K, how do I go ahead to invest, and what should be the amount?
If you're looking at goals which are short term, we will tend to reduce the risk in the investment. And the issue that we find is that people like to keep all their money liquid, because at any point in time, I may use all the money for an international holiday or all the money for my marriage. And we know, actually speaking, it's not true. So there'll be some part of the money which you need to, in your mind, be absolutely clear about, which you're putting aside for long term, saying, okay, this part of the money I will not use for something which is sudden. So there are, everybody has sudden goals, and sometimes they don't have sudden goals, but they have sudden events. And you need to have the ability to pay for those events when they happen. But that doesn't mean that, you know, everything I'll keep absolutely safe. And we know putting cash under the mattress is not safe. It was proved to be 1 year ago. and so it's important for you to have different elements of your investments broken down with different goals. And some of them need to be for a little longer term. Because I'm sure there are some, if I was to sort of probe you a bit, you will have some goals which are a little longer than sudden as well. And what are you doing about them is the question that you need to ask yourself.
Okay, can we have the microphone to the gentleman in grey, please?
As we know, market has reached to its all-time high. Sensex has crossed a mark of 33K. So where do you really see market going in near future? Would you really advise us to invest at this point in time, or be just, you know, wary of the market and have a wait and watch theory?
The point is that, you know, you cannot perfectly time it, and there will be always conflicting views at both points of time. You will also find that when markets are doing very well, everything will be buoyant, and people will say, yeah, you know, it's going to grow very high. So I think don't try to time it. That's a simple, I think, message that we are all saying. Just, you know, do a systematic one. If you're doing a systematic investment and market falls, right, you will be actually happier that, oh, wow, I'm buying when it is falling, I'm buying when it is cheaper. And so the way I look at it, you know, I love volatile times because I think it'll actually enhance returns. Okay, so if you go with that mindset and you're saying, yeah, I'm not invested lump sum, done something rash, then you can actually take advantage of market volatility.
Well, on that note, we're absolutely timed out on this episode of NSE FinWiz. But Mr. Anil Rego and Lavai Navlaki, thank you so much for joining us. And from the entire team that put the show together and all of us here at Puma in Bangalore, thanks for watching.
It was extremely interesting, and specifically because as we see the shift in the working population, more younger population is joining the board. And the most difficult thing that I have seen is how to manage their finances, how to manage savings, how to look at tax computations. The understanding itself does not exist because of the younger workforce.
Event, I mean, the experts that you have called in were superb in terms of knowledge that I have gained through this event was really insightful, and people have been really interactive, and they have, you know, given us really good insights, industry insights.
This one has been very much, educative in terms of everything that we need to know. Generally, the people don't handle the questions directly when it comes to investment, but the experts have clearly handled those questions. And yes, obviously, I'll be changing a couple of things, including my investment plan and the setting of the goals.